Welcome to this short introduction to maintenance jobs in SERTICA. My name is Rasmus Hansen. I'm the head of the project department at Rina Digital Solutions. Today, I'll try to show you how you can improve your use of SERTICA and hopefully optimize your business.
A job inside SERTICA is a registration of work that needs to be done. It can be either a recurring job, meaning that it comes up every year, every month, every week, or it can be a run-once job that is only due to be done once, and after this, the job is closed. We operate with these two types of jobs inside SERTICA. As a user in SERTICA, you can get an overview of the outstanding jobs that needs to be done through the job list. The job list can be found in the bottom left corner, and when you press it, you get a list of the jobs that are scheduled to be done. These are automatically sorted by date, so you get the, how can I say, most critical jobs in the top. Now, red jobs in the job list means that the job is overdue. A green job means that it's a job that has been started, but not yet completed. In this case, I have blue jobs, which are jobs coming up in the near future. And then the black ones are jobs further into the future. To see the details of a job, I simply select it. And that shows me the job description and if any spare parts, documents, and so on is attached. That can be found here in the bottom. Now, to see the details of the job in regards to frequency and so on, you can click twice on the job and that opens up the job screen. The job screen has all the details of the job. We have a number of tabs in the top. And of course, in the bottom, you have what we call triggers, which is the frequency of the job. We have resources, estimated hours, we have estimated spare parts and so on. Now to create a new job is quite easy. When you're on the job screen, you have a button up here called New, and when you press this, you start the process of creating a new job. And you'll see that the only thing that is required to create a new job inside SERTICA is actually the component being the piece of equipment that the job should belong to. So in my case, I'll press the component button here, and that will give me either a choice of searching my component or to have a look at the component structure, and then from there, select the job. In this case, I want to create a job on my main engine number 3. So I select this and that is then transferred to the job. Then I can give it a job name. That's always a good idea. In this case, it's an overhaul job like so. And I can give a job description, of course, like so. You can also attach pictures, PDF files and so on to the job to have further documentation of what needs to be done. When I have the basic information of my job done, I want to put on a frequency. In this case, the overhaul of the engine needs to be done at a certain interval. So I click down here to add a frequency, and I say that this should run on a calendar. Now, in this case, it should be a yearly job, and I want it to come up every 5 years. And I can use this box here, the next possible run date, to define when I want the job to run the next time. And let's say that we want the job to run in 3 days because we've actually forgotten to register it in good time. So I put this frequency on the job, and as soon as I press the save button up here, the job will get what we call a next date. This is the due date of the job, the date when the job should be done the next time. If I go back to my job list, you will see that now my new job actually is present on the list. We have it down here, my overhaul job. When I select it, you can see that there's a description, there's the trigger information, and I can also see any documents and so on that might be attached. So this is how you schedule new jobs inside SERTICA. Another way to look at the jobs could be to look in the actual tree structure where we have our equipment structure. So if I close my screens here and then open up my tree structure, you can see that we have a structure here and I can open this up to drill down to my main engines. And if I have my main engine here and I expand this, you'll see that it also has a folder for the jobs. And if I expand it further, it has recurring jobs and then I have my overhaul job. So this way is also an easy way of getting an overview of the jobs connected to different pieces of equipment. That's how you set up your jobs inside SERTICA. We hope it helps you. Bye.
If you'd like to learn more about SERTICA and our modules, visit our website.